VR and AR, known collectively as XR, are projected to be key technologies in the future of work. Ever since the COVID-19 pandemic, there has been an increased need for remote working, and XR became one of the technologies adopted by enterprises for training, collaboration, data visualization, and customer experience. Furthermore, these technologies are gaining traction in areas like social media and live streaming. Global Data forecasts the VR market to generate revenues of $51 billion by 2030, expanding at a compound annual growth rate of 27% between 2020 and 2030. However, this growth will not be without issue. Meta, formerly Facebook, have been at the forefront of metaverse development, moving away from consumer gaming. Their vision appears to be the creation of a virtual office environment where employees can interact, have meetings, and perform other traditional office-based working practices via realistic-looking avatars. In addition to this, the headsets provide the ability to augment real-world office spaces, providing tools like virtual monitors when using pass-through cameras. While some aspects of development have marked a huge step forward in technology, releases like the $1,500 enterprise-focused MetaQuest Pro headset met with mixed reviews on release. This ultimately proved to be a failure, as reflected in the significant price drops after only a few months, and more recently, rumors of mass unsold Quest Pros being given away at events. Companies like Apple have also recently thrown their hats into the ring with their Vision Pro, which has a more conservative approach to working in VR space, largely operating within sizable virtual screens and featuring a similar user interface to traditional computers. While this has brought one of the most high-profile companies into the space and renewed excitement with aspects like hand gestures and eye-tracking based navigation, as well as high-fidelity pass-through, the extremely high price of $3,500 and the weight of the aluminium frame has some people concerned. The issues currently facing headsets are not easy fixes and will still require some significant developments in technologies like batteries and microcomputing, and a complete rethinking of display and optics technologies to get the size and weight down and the power up. These are important concerns for enterprise use cases, which may require portability and extended use to be effective tools. In the first 9 months of 2022, Meta reportedly lost $9.4 billion. Recently, Meta have been hit with plummeting stock prices and the laying off of 11,000 members of their staff in November 2022. Key team member John Carmack also left Meta at this time, criticizing the efficiency and spending of the company, stating, "We have a ridiculous amount of people and resources, but we constantly self-sabotage and squander effort." Meta's platform, Horizon Worlds, also faced heavy criticism, with Meta employees themselves not being willing to use the platform. In addition to these missteps, Meta have previously faced wide-scale criticism over their misuse of data collection via the Facebook and Instagram platforms, with the VR headsets having multiple cameras and sensors both looking at the user's environment as well as having aspects like body, face, and eye tracking. There is the potential for further, more intrusive data collection by Meta, a concern raised by tech reviewer Marques Brownlee.
Especially this company, having possibly that much control over people and over the future of the internet, and possibly doing crazy things like using eye tracking to make sure you see certain ads, is way too much for me to want to root for it at all.
Other upcoming players include Pico, a Chinese brand owned by TikTok's parent company, ByteDance, with concerns being raised in recent years over Chinese companies' access to data and their links to their government. This may prove to be an area where Apple was able to take advantage, as its history of privacy and security is excellent by comparison. Several initiatives are currently underway to regulate metaverse platforms. For example, South Korea, China, and the European Commission are developing plans and standards to govern the metaverse within their jurisdictions. Despite recent setbacks, enterprises are expected to outpace the currently dominant consumer VR market by 2025. Early successes include technologies like ILM's Stagecraft, known generically as The Volume. This is a large virtual screen-based soundstage for TV and film. This technology allows actors to be physically filmed in CG environments in real time, benefiting from the ambient and reflective lighting missing from green screen sets. Although this technology doesn't use traditional VR headsets in the actual filming process, the volume has benefited from hardware and software associated with VR, like positional tracking systems and Unreal's real-time ray tracing game engine. Because of this, people have managed to set up lower budget proxies of the volume directly using consumer VR products. VR and AR also seem to have found a space in the automotive sector, with car manufacturers utilizing the technology to design and visualize their concepts in a faster and more cost-effective way. Companies like Amazon, Microsoft, and Google, among others, will also benefit from the technology as developers increasingly subscribe to cloud services. In addition, companies like Walmart, Saudi Aramco, and Airbus are using VR in their training programs. Several hardware-related deals have been noted in the last few years, including deals involving Meta, Apple, Google, and TDK, with access to technology as one of the main reasons for M&A activities in the XR markets. In recent months, Meta has had a bit more success, receiving praise for the release of their Quest 3. At $500, this consumer headset takes most of the technology from the much more expensive Quest Pro and improves on aspects like the AR pass-through. With price being the main differentiating factor, this questions whether consumers are willing to pay a premium for technology that clearly has some major hurdles to overcome. This may be indicative of why there has been a recent push towards enterprise. Meta have also released some smart glasses in collaboration with Ray-Bans to generally positive reviews. Although these devices are displayless, they feature some interesting generative AI software, which may hint at where Meta is looking to take XR, or how the industry may start to fragment into different wearables aimed at different use cases. The amount of development, investment in this space, and prominent players involved suggest that VR will become a key technology in the future. However, tech limitations, cost, and user sentiment are currently holding the technology back from the widespread, ubiquitous adoption targeted by the likes of Meta and Apple. Successes in the enterprise and workspaces appear to be coming from new and unique ways people can benefit from the tech, rather than trying to shoehorn traditional work practices into the virtual space.